Welcome to FX Bootcamp London session. My name is Christian Stevens. Today is April 29th, 2008. This is your daily London session video, a review of just some of what we did today in the live London session class at fxbootcamp.com. Today was going to be fun. This whole week is a very big news week for us. We have a well-anticipated U.S. interest rate announcement, as well as a it's non-farm payroll week on Friday. As you can see, looking at the majors here, we definitely had movement tonight. But prior to the London session, things were pretty sleepy, and we were just in a matter of trying to figure out what kind of traps we could put together. We had British pound news coming out throughout the night, so that was going to be spotty. But overall, a fairly technical night was to be expected. I'm going to focus on just a couple of trade plans that we did. There were quite a few. Nice correlated movement across the board for the U.S. dollar, this being one of them. The euro dollar... Let's zoom out here on a 15-minute chart, and just to show you what we had going on here. You see how I identified this? This is right around midnight New York time. Just identified a short, very short-term bottom. And if you back this out, If you back this out, I had a lower high that was creating itself right here, and we had support right around 66, I believe it was. But couldn't tell a whole lot from that. So I pulled out yesterday's. I pulled out the two-hour time frame. This is the two-hour time frame chart showing the last few days, basically Friday onto now on the euro dollar. And what you'll notice is how we have higher lows happening here and lower highs. Maybe a little bit of a triangle going on, and that's pretty much the little bit of sideways action we were experiencing at that time. So. Pretty much a situation where you're looking for a break above or below, and seeing that the bias is definitely to the downside after we broke some of these trend lines on the euro dollar, probably more likely to be down for a little bit of USD strength since we're essentially back at the 5 EMA. Let me show you that on a daily chart. If I can get to it. There you go. That's a zoomed out daily chart on MetaTrader 4. And as you can see, we broke that channel at the break of 160, came down and hit the 5 EMA, 156.93. And now we're kind of relaxing on the 5 EMA. Now, obviously, that red candle you see on the daily shows the price action as it took place after that. But we're trying to set up a price trap ahead of time. And what you have between these two lines is about a 50 pip trap on a two-hour chart. So, let me go back to that. So what you're hoping here is a break, and you're measuring the distance between the first bottom and the top of this just to kind of get an idea if it does break, where might it go? And you just project it, and what you end up with is something like this. Target right around 54.75, which is really cool. Whoops. Because if you... can't seem to center that right. If you go back to the high and you do a fib study, let me get all these things out of here. From the last swing, which by the way, I'm doing that swing off of this spike here, looks like middle of last week. Okay, since obviously we came down, rose up to that point. What you have is a fib happening here, which would indicate maybe a fib extension, which overlaps roughly with that area. Not to mention, I believe we had some other pivots and things of that nature. But you know what? That's a long way off, that 54.75. Really, we know that we've got some support well before that at 55.86 and ultimately in the 55.50 area. But still, it's a good idea to have some kind of an idea of where you're going with this. 55.50 is also today's 55 EMA on the daily. Anyway, let's go back to a 15-minute chart and see how we're able to build a trade plan around this. Very short term, just set yourself a little alarm outside of this 56.30 range, which is approximately the bottom of that triangle on the two-hour and above the 60 area on the upside. And just essentially, you see a 5.8 cross happening, a break of the 55, and right after that, you got stochastic cross, and you're breaking your line, making a lower low for the day. So either you're taking a break or you're waiting for a retest. Most people, including myself, would take a break there. Your retest on a 15-minute chart may just look like a wick on a one-minute chart. It looks more like a normal fib, but if you do a fib study, that's a 382. And you pretty much, as you can see, drop from that point on. Okay? Adjust this out here. Show you this on an hourly time frame. Now, this is that same period of time that's occurring. All this zoomed in stuff on the 15 minute is that same period of consolidation on the euro dollar during on the hourly chart during that time. So what you're at is the daily central pivot point while you're just sitting still. The very next candle you could see is that drop that break we're getting. So you're starting at the central pivot point. You're at least targeting, pivot theory says you're targeting a central pivot point to a S2 pivot point day, which is about 100 pips or so. And if you take a quick look at the weekly pivots, we don't really have anything in the way until the weekly S1 at 54.50, which is around our overall target. So that's really not a concern. So, you're essentially looking for at least a 100 pip trade here. So either you took the break, the retest to the 5 EMA, or you waited for an overall retest of this move if you missed it here and you got in at 56.30. However you handle that, you're in somewhere in the, let's just call it 56, 56.25 to 56.35 area. Unless you took a break prior to this low after the 5.8 cross and the break of the 55 and you're at 40. This is happening while you're getting USD correlation across the board. There are entries on dollar Swissy very similarly, pound dollar, Aussie dollar, New Zealand dollar. This is just one of them. And you can see what happens from that point on. And we ride all the way down and essentially hit the S2 to the pip. 48, let me zoom back here, get the whole hourly on there. Since then, we've lingered around, we hit the S2 for the week and have malingered around the M1, and that's where we are right now. So that was just one of the trade plans we did. It was a very easy little ride to five with a retest right around here. If you got in on the first retest after the break, you made about 98 pips, give or take, depending upon where you took profit at. Always take profit at the S2. We always take profit at the S2 reversal pivot point, even if it's going to go further, which sometimes it will do. Sometimes you'll get a bounce off S2 back to the scene of the crime, so to speak, at M1 with a continuation. We actually call that a move trade. But we were sitting outside the Bollinger Band for so long that you weren't sure if that was going to happen. Look at the daily chart again, and you can see right now that we have reach the daily 55 as well at that level, as well as the being a psychological level of 55.50. We'll see what happens for the New York session, but it was a fairly easy 100 pips, quite frankly. You had a clue going back to when it hit S2 that you might be about to get a rise. You can see the stochastics were starting to peak upwards as price was reaching the S2 at 48. So you had some clues that maybe take profit was in order. Anyway, that's just one of the trade plans we did. Another one was the Aussie dollar. I'm going to switch over to that real quick. Aussie dollar, if you can look at the past couple of days, this shaded area here is Sunday. So that's Friday, then the weekend, and Sunday, and Monday, and this today being Tuesday. And just connecting this peak here and all these wicks, along with the higher lows we were experiencing the first part of today. Let me zoom into that. All you really had to do was take a quick look at gold to make sure that it was correlated. You see how we have high lows, higher lows here? You're waiting for your next 5.8 cross. And this is what the gold commodity looked like at the time. This is a 1 hour chart on gold. Let me zoom that in and show you what we were looking at. And what you pretty easily were able to identify is a rising bottom on the gold commodity as well. So what you have is a triangle happening on Aussie dollar and on rising bottom. I'm sorry, not triangle, on Aussie dollar and on gold. And ironically enough, right after we got the break on Aussie dollar, we got the break on gold in a similar fashion, as you can see. Now this one did not end up. Let me go back to the GFT chart. So we ended up being pretty good pips, but did not end up getting to our target, which was right around 92.5. But it did stop at the M1 reversal pivot point. And basically all you're doing here is taking a break of this right around 60, I think it was, 62, something like that. If you waited for a retest on this one, you did get it very briefly, the retest of the trend line broke before it took off to the downside, as you could see. So this happened right pretty much at the beginning of the London session with a very quick retest entry. Pop this back out here. The problem you have is you're also running into, I could draw this real quick. an overlap on the daily. You're also running into an overlap of a 618 Fibonacci retracement of this rise from 9200 to 9570 that overlaps with the previous downtrend line that we had broken. We're back at that line, and if you see that red line there, that is also the daily 21. So there's a lot right there, and we'll see what's going to happen with the New York session. Another thing that gave you a reason to believe this was going to happen before the break is you were rolling off of the 21.55 combo in the 4-hour, getting a 5-8 cross. So maybe we're ultimately heading to 92 and 80 or so. I don't know. We'll see. But certainly an easy, depending upon where you took entry at M1. If you got out at M1, you took an easy ride here of right around 50-ish pips. Those are just two of the trade plans we did today at fxbootcamp.com. We had quite a few others. There was quite a bit of extension. And obviously, the pound, which, by the way, this little drop here, if I zoom back, pound dollar, that is, this was effectively the same drop that we had here on the euro, and was very playable and just very, very much did a nice continuation retest. And then the CBI news came out this morning that was just horrific, and that's the second red candle. We essentially dropped another 100 pips. So fantastic continuation on the British pound USD. There are quite a number of trade plans today. Those are just a couple of them. If you'd like to learn how to do these trade plans yourself on a regular basis, please come stop by and see us at fxbootcamp.com. Otherwise, hope you guys have a great week. This has been your daily London session video, Tuesday, April 29th, 2008. You guys have a good one. Cheers.